the Tide and the Bulldogs, the SEC on CBS, the best game from the best conference.
We welcome all of you to the Home Depot SEC on CBS this afternoon from Starkville, SEC Western County. The Crimson Tide of Alabama against the Mississippi State Bulldogs. Take a look at the current SEC West standings. Alabama with a big victory last week, plus some help when Arkansas defeated Ole Miss, controls their own destiny, and there is a way for Mississippi State to get to Atlanta to take on Florida. Hi, once again, everybody. Vern Lundquist, along with Gary Danielson. We welcome you to Starkville. Not Starkville, Starkville. And a much-anticipated game. Gary, we saw Alabama last week probably as good as they have played all year long.
Yeah, that was a beatdown, wasn't it? And, you know, a lot of the talk after was about the Alabama defense, and they deserved to have talk after the football game. But something else emerged in that game. Derrick Henry took control of this football game and maybe a shot at the Heisman. That weapon all evening was such that Alabama could dial it up and keep any defense uncomfortable. But also, most Alabama teams, when you look at them in the past, they've got that second running back. And I thought the emergence and play of Kenyon Drake was a huge lift for the football team, and I think it'll be important for the rest of the season for Alabama and something Mississippi State must stop.
Mississippi State had a great year a year ago, lost a few folks, and got off to a tough start. They have been under the radar all year, but they're 7-2, and they have Dak Prescott.
Yeah, they sure do. I mean, you know, Dak Prescott had this team a year ago as the number one team in the country coming into this football game, and he's better this year. He's a better thrower, he's just as good a leader, and he's able to run the football. I mean, this is going to be the complete opposite game that we had a week ago with LSU.
So how does Mississippi State contend in this?
Well, I took a little work here, and what I think is Mississippi State has a lot going for them, Vern. You know, they got the home field advantage. They're well-rested. They've got the big wide receiver. They play the spread. Big game experience. They got a lot going for them.
Yeah.
So does Alabama. They're really, really good.
Well, now I know why you don't play golf during the week. Come up with stuff like that.
All the skills.
First on the field, the Bulldogs of Mississippi State. And right behind them, the Crimson Tide of Alabama, who have won 7 in a row against MSU. And a moment ago, Allie LaForce with Mississippi State coach Dan Mullen.
Coach, you said that last year against Alabama, the team played tight. They were trying to play too perfect. How has the mentality and approach changed now a year later?
I think it's great. Our guys have been in this type of atmosphere and situation, been in big-time games before. We got to just go out, play our game, execute at a high level, and have fun out here on the field.
Mississippi State leads the SEC and plays over 20 yards. How can you be that explosive against this Alabama defense?
Well, you're going to have to if you're going to beat them, because they're pretty tough to give up those. You don't want to be in a 1-2-3-yard battle up inside against them. So we're going to have to make some of those big explosive plays today.
Thank you, Coach. Good luck.
Thank you.
Vern, I think Mississippi State would like a Big 12 game out here today. They wanted 44-41.
Really?
They'll take their chances.
Okay. It is a beautiful afternoon in Starkville, 65 degrees, and no rain in the forecast. Perfect mid-November SEC weather. The 100th all-time meeting, the first one back in 1896, and Alabama has won 7 in a row. The Crimson Tide won the toss. They elected to defer the option till the second half of the game. And Brandon Holloway, 9th in the NCAA, returning kicks. He'll take a knee. Dak Prescott coming on the field. He is in possession of 36 Mississippi State University Bulldog records at the quarterback position. Just a marvelously gifted young man.
Sure is. He's got all the records, and he's one win against Alabama from being a legend.
He'll throw, perhaps. That I added perhaps. That's A'shaun Robinson, who continues his big play.
Yeah, I guess they brought A'shaun Robinson from last week. If you watched the game a week ago, A'shaun Robinson basically, I know he didn't do it by himself, but it seemed like it at times.
Loss of 7, second 17. Prescott keeps it. Now let's cue the cow and get the Chick-fil-A starting lineup introduced to you. Offensively for MSU, Warren Malone, one of the better offensive linemen and the only senior starter. Wally is back in the lineup. He missed a few with injury at tight end. And they really do run by committee. Prescott is the leading rusher. That's enough to move the chain. Devonyet Wilson, number one. Quickly, the defensive unit. Allen Robinson Reed Duvall. Minka Fitzpatrick, he of the two interceptions for touchdowns against A&M. We expect to see a lot today because of the offensive style of Mississippi State. Second sack in four plays.
This time, I think it's Jonathan Allen, number 93. And if you can just get the secondary to force Prescott off his first choice, Alabama believes the front four will get to him. The key to the game, I talked to Kirby Smart, he believes, is can his front four put pressure and produce some sacks against Dak? Well, so far, they have, right?
Yep, two of them out of four offensive plays. Prescott, nothing on the left side. Reuben Foster was there to make the tackle.
Shumpert, 32, will not come into the game. He's their best blitz pickup running back. And as I say that, they split him out and go empty. Guess that's not why he's in the game.
Third down. Stunts defensively. Prescott can't escape. Yeah. He does get back to the line of scrimmage, but that was about it. Yeah. Dalvin Tomlinson had a great escape around the left edge.
You know, it's a combination always. The big guys up front and the coverage in the back end. Nowhere safely to throw the football. And Dak early in this football game took discretion and said, I'll eat the football and punt it. Now, early in the game a year ago, the punting was a problem for Mississippi State. They shanked two of their first three punts.
Logan Cook is the punter. And this one's not particularly long.
Bad play.
Cyrus Jones let it go inadvisedly. And Mississippi State picks up 15 extra yards.
Yeah, I'm really surprised Cyrus Jones didn't make a play on that one. It did cost them between 15 and 20 yards.
So it results in a 55-yard punt. You'll see number two on the field, Derek Henry, when we return. Jake Coker has started every game save one this year. That one was the loss to Ole Miss at home, and it's time for the Cow to come on stage and the Chick-fil-A starting lineup. Cam Robinson, Pierce Baker, Ryan Kelly, four-year starter, graduate student now, the anchor of this offensive line. There's Kelly.
Well, Vernon, it'd be hard to pick out a guy who didn't have a good game last week, but I think between Kelly and I think Cam Robinson, left tackle, having his best game of the year, that was great news for Alabama fans.
Coker came on in replacement of Cooper Bateman in that loss to Ole Miss at home. There he fires out right side. Quick catch by Kenyon Drake. And let's check the Bulldog defense now. Brown, James Jones, Jefferson, Richie Brown having a really solid season. So also is Boniquas Brown, number 42. Coker dropped. Calvin Ridley.
You know, Vern, that ball went from the sun to the shadow right there, and that might have thrown Ridley off. Early in this game, with this fall sun, the Alabama receivers here are looking directly into the sun when they look back. And when it goes from the bright to the dark, that can throw you off.
Derrick Henry, deep back in the eye. That's O.J. Howard. Play action. Coker still has it, being chased. And lobs it into the bench.
Our guys on the field pregame did a good shot of what that sun is like early in this football game. When you're looking back on it, that's what you're dealing with. And Mississippi State gets a three and out, partly because of a drop ball and then great pressure on third down and good coverage downfield.
That brings on the sophomore J.K. Scott, big factor in this game a year ago, when Alabama scored 19 unanswered points early. Mississippi State did fight back. Here's a whistle before the punt.
Just to give you an example of the hidden yardage in this game.
Hard snap.
J.K.
Full start. Offense number 7. Have your opportunity.
J.K. had 7 punts for 319 yards. Mississippi State, 5 punts for 172. That's hidden yards that doesn't show up in the stats, but you're right, J.K. Scott had a huge game last year.
Well, that's a modest start this afternoon. He's guilty of the false start. And he really is a sophomore out of Denver. Had a sensational first year here and then got off to a very slow start the first 3 or 4 games of the year, but has come on recently.
No, not a good one.
Nope. Fair catch. Call
nope,
for
nope.
pick.
He did.
I thought he was waving it off. So he gets to the 48.
Boy, a lot of combinations of misplays by Alabama there. Remember, they let the pump roll. Then they have the drop pass, and now a bad punt. Those little things.
Good field position, MSU. Our home Duco tools for success.
You know, Vern, they always look for trends that what might give Alabama trouble. And if you look at it in the 9 losses that Nick Saban has had in the SEC, one trend is big receivers have given them problems. These are the receivers in the 9 losses that they face, and Mississippi State has a pair of them. And Daronya Wilson and Freddie Ross, they got 2 big guys that in one-on-one matches and matchups all over the field, they should give the quarterback, Dak Prescott, a lot of confidence to throw that football.
Mississippi State takes over at the 47. Brandon Holloway dumps it, tips incomplete.
I think that's the 7th play of the game for Mississippi State, and it's the 5th time Dak Prescott has been hit. 4 of them on passes, and remember on that run, that bootleg run. So 5 of the 7 plays, they have put the pads on the quarterback.
Prescott, left side, man for man, incomplete.
Now comes the flag.
Hit. Tyvus Jones defending on Donald Gray.
Donald Gray is a speedster. Now, he's not a tall speedster, but he is a speedster.
Number 5. Generally, 15 yards to the previous spot. and includes an automatic first down.
You know, Vern, I thought Allie's question to Dan and what we talked to Dan Mullen on Friday about, when we went back and watched the tape, it did appear that Mississippi State was tight in that football game. But what I was surprised to hear is Dan Mullen admit that he was tight in the game. He tried to do too much. He tried to be too perfect. He said, in this game, we're just going to run our base offense and let it go.
That does include the quarterback keeper up the middle.
But that's another body punch. See, I mean, that's the challenge when you are the running attack and the passing attack for Mississippi State. Now, you know, it was a one-man attack a week ago by Leonard Fournette. It's basically a one-man attack this week, only this guy can throw and run.
He wants to throw here.
Oh, boy.
Fumble. That ball is out, I believe. No, no, no. Now they're going to say Ryan Anderson hit Prescott.
Yeah, that, there's no doubt about it. And that front four coming around the corner, and it is Ryan Anderson who had the big sack before. And that ball was out and recovered on the play because Senior just said, Justin said, I got you hit. I better pick up the ball.
Number 58, Justin Senior. That's a loss of 11.
Boy, they just keep going empty.
Oh,
empty,
boy.
Empty, empty, empty.
Here comes the rush. Little pass left side. He's going to get a bunch back, but not quite enough.
Let's see if Mississippi State goes hurry up and goes for it on fourth down. It was a little wide receiver screen to the backside, and yes, they are going to go hurry up. Alabama does get their subs on the field.
Needed 20, got 18. Fourth and three. Let's make it officially 17 now. Why quibble over a yard?
That's one thing. The biggest improvement I've seen with the adjustment from Alabama is how they handle the hurry up. They get their players on the field.
Eight on the play clock. Option. Pitch. First down. Red Ross, number eight.
Well, Alabama played it fine. They played assignment football. They were ready for the option. But Eddie Jackson, watch Eddie Jackson come up on the play. He's got him. But one-on-one, you make a guy miss. And that's a first down.
Holloway going left, darts to the left, slices to the corner, and is downed a yard short of the first down. Touchdown.
Freddie Ross, number eight, got a block. Just enough of a slowdown on Fitzpatrick that allowed the speed of Holloway to get there.
This is Holloway, who now moves to the right side. Darian Hutcherson, number 84, goes left, the tight end. Prescott batted back, and then he has to bat it down.
That's a great play by both sides there. You know, you got to give both sides great play on this one. You bat the ball down, and then Dak Prescott realizes, I don't want it back here. I've got the ball in the 2 or 3 yard line. I don't want to catch it on the 10-yard line or 8-yard line.
That was Reggie Ragland was the Alabama player, and then Prescott knocked it down. Second and goal. Nice defensive job by Cyrus Jones.
Well, Mississippi State fans right now are reminded of the last drive of the first half of a year ago when they had the ball down at the end of the half and Alabama had that goal line stand. Remember, they threw the fade pass and then they missed a wide open pass. There was a legal procedure penalty there. Can Alabama get a stop again?
Here's Prescott. Doesn't get it.
Decision time. Decision time for Dan Mullen.
What do you think? How many opportunities will you have?
I go for it.
Would you? Okay.
Sure. Especially you're going to give Alabama the ball on the 1 yard line if you don't make it.
Fourth and goal. Prescott.
Nothing.
Ball will go over on downs. Denzel Duvall was the first man there.
Sure did. Came around the corner. At the point of attack, there were guys as well. But coming around the corner, Duvall gets it. But look at on the other side. I think it was Anderson, Ryan Anderson. He got him from one side, and Duvall from the other side. Oh, it's Dylan Lee's there,
yes.
Too, by the way. He's coming off back-to-back. Great game a week ago. And Kirby Smart's defense let him go all the way down the field. He got the big stop. That's that big check mark, Vern. The big check mark. They're good, and they got a lot of good players.
Jake Coker 5 yards into the end zone. That's Calvin Ridley in motion. And
12 men on the field for Mississippi State, I believe.
Legal substitution, 12 players in the formation. Defense, 5 yard penalty. First down.
Goes all the way till when the snap is imminent, and then they're going to throw that flag. The back judge will call it. Well, we could count it out there somewhere, but I guarantee you there's 12 players out there.
Now Alabama spreads it. Four men to the left side, one wide right. That's Henry in motion and stops alongside his quarterback. Right side, Calvin Ridley.
We left before that last commercial. Ridley was looking up at that sun, you know, right there. And that ball actually went from the shadow to the sun to the shadow again. So he's adjusted.
Looked like A.J. Jefferson wrapped up Coker.
Oh, goodness.
It's silly.
And it didn't have to be much more than that.
No. And the flag came out, and the steps are walked off.
And now all of a sudden, Alabama, who was backed up, you know, and it looked like such a good move by Dan Mullen to try to pick up that touchdown. Now all of a sudden, Bama's out where they can use their whole offense here.
Up the middle she goes, Derrick Henry.
I visited with Lane Kiffin, who called such a great game for Alabama a week ago on the field before the game. I said, what are you looking at with these guys? And he said, no one has pushed around the front four for Mississippi State. I think we'll have better success running wide than between the tackles. But you know what? That one right there worked.
This one doesn't.
Yep.
Henry again.
The Mississippi State defense of Manny Diaz is built on tackles for loss. We talked to him yesterday, and he says, listen, we know they're going to pick up 5 yards, 12 yards, 8 yards. What we want to do is get them behind the chains. If we can get tackles for a loss and give up for the big play, I like our chances.
And this Alabama team has been susceptible to tackles for loss this year. Here's Coker. Protection breaks down. He one-hops it out to the left side. Let's go to Adam Zucker in our New York studio for a Ford update.
And by the way, Vern, don't sleep on Keenan Reynolds getting some votes for the Heisman. And I think it would be a tremendous vote for Keenan Reynolds.
Play action, Coker. Under duress.
Well, they got it wrong.
Intercepted. Picked off by Brandon Bryant. Red shirt freshman. That is the first interception Coker has thrown on the road.
It's a read route. The receiver can come down here and break in or break out. Watch, our Darius Stewart goes one way, And Kofler thinks he's going to go the other way. Ardarius Stewart goes inside. Kofler has the read that he's going to go outside. And Jake wakes up and goes, what? There has to be rules, and one of the two players didn't read the same rule as the other one.
Time call. Davis Wade Stadium and Scott Field in Starkville. No score. Let's go look at that interception again.
Well, there's A.J. Jefferson right there. He usually plays defensive end, but in this pass rush situation, he's inside on the nose tackle. And two plays in a row, he got pressured and forced Kofler to throw it just a half second early. That makes up for that shove back there near the goal line.
And on the turnover, here goes Aris Williams for a couple up the middle, running back. Never miss a moment of college football with the CBS Sports app. Every play, score, every game, and every highlight, right as they happen. Download the CBS Sports app now.
Well, Dan Mullen's trying to give him a Big 12 offense, isn't he? I mean, it's been empty probably three-fourths of the plays.
Prescott, feeling pressure, has a man open. Darunya Wilson coming on the crossing pattern in perfect stride, makes the catch first down.
Well, gave Alabama a little piece of their own medicine on this one. A short split by the wide receiver, number one, Darunya Wilson, and then a crossing of the routes right there. Eddie Jackson couldn't get there quick enough, and what a good timing that time by Dak Prescott.
Gain of 22, first down 10, blitz. Prescott cut, and there's a slip at the 15-yard line. No flag.
Same deal on that one. Reuben Foster, number 10, forced Prescott to throw it just a step early, meaning you have to pick out a spot, and obviously when you're trying to throw it and guess where the receiver is, it's hard to do.
4:51 to go opening quarter. No score. There was a threat. Prescott stopped on fourth and goal. Into the flat, double team tackle on Aris Williams, a freshman.
Just so different watching Alabama substitute than the way they substituted 3 or 4 years ago. When Texas A&M and Missouri came into this league and started going more up-tempo, Alabama was caught a bit flat-footed. Not anymore. They substitute just beautifully.
Prescott again kept in check. And it'll be fourth down. Deshaun Hand, number 9. Boy, they will run bodies in and out,
oh,
Gary.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. They play around 11 or 12 front five players. I mean, defensive tackles, defensive ends, and outside linebackers. They call them jacks, but they really line up at the line of scrimmage. And I'm going to tell you, I think at least 10 of them will play in the NFL.
Logan Cook on the punt. Put that nose down. Oh, beautiful.
Yep.
Wow. Had a little divot.
And a year ago, it was Alabama controlling field position. So far, it's been Mississippi State.
32-yard punt, perfectly placed. All right, Adam, thank you, and how quickly the Heisman list can change, as we saw last Saturday night.
Yeah, we kept one open because it could really be anyone grab that last spot. Well, I mean, this, it could be Dak Prescott if he chooses a win today. But, you know, right at the end, if you have a third vote, you've got two guys you like, wouldn't mind writing down Keenan Reynolds down there.
Yeah, I agree
what
with
a
you.
Career.
First down, 10, second time. They toss it, and Kenyon Drake comes around the left side. Jay Coker has felt some pressure this year.
Yeah, it started out that way in the old Miss game. This was a problem, and Jake was still letting it fly in the games, and he got some turnovers because of it. When you're throwing like that under duress and trying to make plays, it can happen, and very reminiscent of what happened to him early in this game. The run-pass ratio here is very interesting for Alabama. Only two rushes in the game.
Here's one up the middle. Henry that close to breaking it. Denequis Brown made the tackle. Number 42. Brings up third down. 2:44 to go, opening quarter. Lane Kiffin calling the play on third and one. Nothing. Fourth down.
Attacking defense. I'll tell you, that's why it was Denequis Brown, number 42. He and Richie Brown, 39, the two inside linebackers, watch more tape and are better at recognizing plays than I think any pair or duo in the league. And I'll tell you, I thought the Florida pair were the best, but these guys are as good as them.
That brings on J.K. Scott. Fred Ross waits at the
another
50.
Bad one. Boy.
Yes.
A little flip from a year ago. The field position goes to Mississippi State, and J.K. Scott is struggling early.
Well, doubleheader for you. The NFL on CBS tomorrow. The lead game early, Cleveland at Pittsburgh. And the lead game late, New England against the New York Giants. And it all begins with JB and the quartet. The NFL today, tomorrow, presented by Southwest Airlines. CBS, the home of the 50th Super Bowl. Prescott. That was a whistle.
We talked about Dak taking a few hits in this game. Whether he's been throwing the ball on sacks or running the ball, dumping it off on the bootlegs, he has felt the Alabama physical side of their defense.
Right there.
I don't think there was a flag. I think everybody was a little bit confused.
Yes, I thought I heard one, obviously. Incorrect.
Being told that Alabama declined the penalty and they might get a fumble recovery.
Ashton Shumpert, the ball carrier.
Shumpert, the ball carrier.
Ball's loose. Does it go back to him? No. Looks like for sure Alabama's got that football. You know, in the 9 SEC losses that Alabama has suffered since Nick turned the program around in 2008. Who was it, Ryan Anderson that got that fumble? Vern? Right. Vern had it. There's one other common thread. The turnover margin has been dominated by Alabama. They've only forced 5 turnovers. That could be 6 if they lose the game there. But 18 turnovers they've collected in those 9 losses. Alabama has turned the ball over in the losses.
Well, they even the turnover battle with this fumble recovery by Ryan Anderson, and now timeout called by Alabama.
Yes.
A referee today, by the way, Ken Williamson. Celebrate Thanksgiving with a bang, a big bang. Catch an all-new episode of TV's number one comedy, The Big Bang Theory, Thursday at 8, 7 Central, only CBS.
Big Bang Theory might be the only team that can rival the dynasty run of Alabama, I'll tell you the truth. They've got a nice run, too.
Well, when Nick turns around, there you see he's got a cut on his left cheek.
Wonder if they're going to put him in the tent. Keep Allie from figuring out what happened there.
Boker. One hops it. Nick James with the pressure. Well,
that's early in the game. Oh my gosh, we're all over it. I'll tell you that.
Cut himself shaving.
No, it didn't. That was, that's a little bit even too in depth for me. Boy, they are attacking Mississippi State.
You gotta believe, Brown.
Excuse me, Vern. You gotta believe Manny Diaz felt like Alabama was gonna try to run the ball, and they attack. And as you said, Brown is there, but the State coming off the edge, everybody just felt the lane there.
I know it's early, but right now, Derrick Henry looks like Leonard Fournette from last Saturday night.
Well, it can get late early in these games, as Fournette earned last week.
Loss of two. Coker. Caught by Richard Mullaney. Transfer from Oregon State, but didn't get enough.
Yeah, sometimes, Vern, the pass rush can affect your next throw. Watch our Darius Stewart come wide open in the middle for a first down. But Jake Coker has been feeling that pressure, and a first down throw is available to him, and he dumps it off too fast. That's what that pass rush can do to you. It can just build on
it. Here's J.K. Scott, ineffective so far in the game. This one high and out of bounds. This one is effective. Judged to be out of bounds at the 13-yard line with 7 seconds to go in the opening quarter. Monday on The Late Show with Stephen Colbert. Don't miss Bill Maher. Then Tuesday, Stephen welcomes Julianne Moore and Burt Reynolds. All new, only CBS. No score, one threat. Prescott deep, man for man. Donald Gray.
You just got to keep attacking the man-to-man coverage. Marlon Humphrey relaxes for half a second. He thinks the play's over. Watch it right here. Watch him glance back, and then Donald Gray kind of throws him off. He looks back. When he looks back, he pushes away, and he gets away with it. And I'll tell you, Nick Saban is all over the officials about Donald Gray getting a push off on the play.
That's a pretty good punctuation mark to end the first quarter. A 54-yard pass will return to Starkville after this message and a word from your local station. To Starkville, Mississippi, Wade Davis Field at Scott, Wade Davis Stadium at Scott Field, Vern Lundquist, Gary Danielson, Allie LaForce. Scoreless game thus far. And Mississippi State, first down 10 at the Alabama 33. Following that 54-yard pass, reverse. Back it goes to Prescott. Well, that was all kind of wacky. No, it didn't look like Arkansas Ole Miss last week.
No, that's for sure.
Well, what's the best thing in your mind that's happened through the first 15 minutes for each team?
For each team? I think for Mississippi State is Dak Prescott's thrown for 100 yards. I think he has to throw for over 300 in this game. For Alabama, it's that it's still tied. You know, I mean, as you looked at that play, they had that goal line stand to keep it at zeros. And I think the other part is that their four-man pass rush got to Dak a couple times. But listen, This is no surprise to me. If you can throw the ball effectively against Alabama, you have a chance. You can't beat them without a quarterback. You just don't have a chance to beat them without a guy who can stretch that defense. And that's what Dak has done in the game so far.
Well, he's got a third down and nine.
Now, the trick play that Mullen teed up on first down was defended beautifully by Alabama.
Prescott. Incomplete, fourth down. Let's see if we see the field goal unit. And third down. Four.
One of the things you have to do against the Alabama defense is read their coverages. They play a lot of combos, a lot of shifting coverages that morph to where your receivers are. So you have to read it and get to the open spots. That means the quarterback and the receiver have to both read it correctly. Miscommunication, but it wasn't an interception. When Alabama miscommunicated, it was an INT.
Weston Graves, this would be a career long if successful. He kicks it from 50 yards out, and it is short. Graves' previous long, or his current long, 44 yards. There it is.
As they say, never up, never in, right?
That's what they say, and sometimes they say, doink. I don't know if that qualified as a full
doink.
Didn't
hit anything.
No. No score as we begin or continue quarter number two. And a missed field goal. Do you see any evidence of a similarity to Mississippi State this year, last year?
I don't. I really don't. I thought last year this Mississippi State team tried to do too much. Remember, they started off second series with a sack. They made a lot of mistakes that I thought they just looked tight. This time, I think they're wide open. They're just not converting on it. I don't think that's the problem. I think they're ready for the football game. They're playing a good football team. You don't have your A game against Alabama if you don't win. But I do think they're playing much looser than a year ago.
Well, they missed the 50-yard field goal. Crimson Tide takes over at the 32. Calvin Ridley, top of the screen. Coker. He looked deep. Double covers way down there. And nothing doing here as Derrick Henry is stopped by Kevon Coleman, number one, number 11.
Well, Tevez Calhoun had one-on-one out here against Ridley. Watch it. It's a slant and go, and it's defended perfectly. That's where the ball was tried. That was the object of the play, and that's why Coker had to dump it off. Good defense. Nobody's on the slot. This is a misalignment by Mississippi State.
Coker keeps it, cuts to the outside. Well, our sleuth, Allie LaForce, has been investigating, and she's got some answers. Allie.
Vern and Gary, this is my first time ever doing an injury report on a head coach, but I can tell you that the cut on Nick Saban's cheek, we're being told, came from one of his players who accidentally ran into him as he was running off the field. Good news is he did not have to visit the tent.
Here's Coker near side. Richard Mullaney, the intended receiver.
I'll tell you, this Mississippi State defense of Manny Diaz is on the receivers. At time, came in number 11, was in coverage, and if you don't throw it perfect, it's going to be incomplete. Defense for Mississippi State is gaining more and more confidence as the game goes on.
Well, Alabama is zip for five on third down conversions. CBS coverage of the Home Depot SEC will continue from Starkville after this message and a word from your local station. Starkville, Alabama, and Mississippi State. Let's catch you up to date on the SEC West standings presented by Dr. Pepper. Alabama 5-1. LSU plays Arkansas tonight. Ole Miss off Mississippi State, and as we said when we came on the air, they can, through a circumstance, a series of circumstances.
Go ahead, explain that, Vern.
I'm not about to. You be the analyst.
Oh, goodness.
We'd have to take a nice pause from this game, and I think everybody wants to watch the game, don't they?
Yeah, I think so. Dan Mullen, seventh year.
Yeah, what a job rebuilding this program. 20-5 in the last 25. How about that?
Equals the mark set by the guy on the other sideline. Quick hitter, Brandon Holloway over the right side. Last 25 games for Mississippi State. That's the best stretch since one of us in this booth was alive. Prescott, total touchdowns. Got it. Gus Wally, the tight end, missed three in the middle of the season with an injury, but back now.
Just to give you an example of how this Mississippi State offense is gaining confidence, if you count the last two quarters of last year's game when Mississippi State put 280 on Alabama, and then you include the first quarter and the last three quarters, State has put over 400 yards on this Alabama defense.
Here's Prescott. This is where he can sometimes hurt you. Minka Fitzpatrick with a fine tackle.
Nothing there. Good coverage. Yet the field gets closed down very quickly with the elite athletes in that secondary.
Second down, 7. Prescott.
Don't you get the feeling no matter how many times Prescott fakes, they're going to be looking for him to keep it afterwards?
I think so. Yes, I do. And for the game so far, ...12 carries, but only for minus 4 yards, because of course in college ball they deduct yardage lost passing from the rushing total. Almost picked off. Ooh.
Well, he had to throw that backing up, and if he did not, it would have been another sack. To try to gimmick a throw over the middle by getting a little pick play. But Dak buys time, and boy, I thought that could have been picked up by Foster. He was standing right there.
So fourth down, Logan Cook is on to punt, and Cyrus Jones is the deep man. This returnable.
Yes, better. Much more aggressive.
Jones. He's got the block. Now he's got an angle, and it's a foot race to the corner. Touchdown, Alabama. There are no flags.
There's lightning in the bottle all over this football field for Alabama. They almost made a play on the interception, and then the punt comes back, and another great athlete gets his hands on the football.
That has not been a strength for Alabama, surprisingly, this year. Cyrus Jones, previous long, had been 27 yards this season. But special teams give the Crimson Tide the first opening of the game.
Well, Cyrus Jones was more aggressive this time. This is after the catch, but you can see as they let it go, they've got the players in the perfect spot. Actually, there wasn't really too many blocks there. Once he beat the first wave, he was gone. The punt was short. Early in the game, he let it bounce. This time, he aggressively goes for it, makes one guy miss. He splits the coverage, and it's
basking in the sunlight on the bench. His 69-yard punt return has put Alabama on top. Was there a block in the back?
Yeah, I think so. Mika Fitzpatrick, bottom of your screen, number 29, gets Logan Cook from behind. Didn't look too much there, but watch another angle, the same one. Fitzpatrick comes in and clearly gets Cook from behind. Shoves him. Now, is that enough? If I was in maroon, I'd think so. I don't know. That it happens so much,
yes,
on those returns. It's hard to believe the officials don't see them, because it pops out at you all the time. We kept trying to, during the commercial break, try to find it, because it looked like something happened, but just a nudge often can be just enough.
Ball goes off the tee, so it'll be reset.
I know a lot of people might say, well, Logan Cook might not have made that tackle anyway, but that's not the way the rules are read.
Right. Taken by Brandon Holloway at the two. Wonderful special teams effort defensively. That's Marlon Humphrey, number 26, made the tackle. 10:37 to go in the quarter. 7-0 first half.
Well, you know, Vern, we talk about all the yards that Mississippi State has gotten. You know what they haven't gotten, though? Points in this matchup. Dan Mullen is 0-6 against Alabama. It's the only team in the West he hasn't beaten. And if you really look at it, it's points. They've only scored more than 10 points once against Alabama, and that was last year. They're averaging 8 points a game against Alabama in this 0-for-6 run.
That pass from Prescott about 2 feet too high. Well, remember, they came in as the number one team in the country last year. They had risen to that number one spot faster than anyone in Division I history. And then they got spanked. They were down 19-0. They did come back and wound up losing 25-20. But then the remainder of the season was not so spectacular. There's Holloway. Wound up losing the Egg Bowl up in Oxford, and then lost the bowl game.
Watch the blocks to the outside here on this little screen. The Alabama players do not get blocked. Two players throw at him, two players get the hands on him from Alabama, and neither one of them gets knocked down. I almost was right there.
Well, I was just stretching my elbows.
Man,
another sack. Yeah.
Oh, boy. That's the best news for Alabama. They have been able to put pressure on Dak with just four guys, and that's not a big surprise. I think everybody who's watched this team play, this might be the best pass rushing unit that Alabama's ever had. And that time coming from the outside, it's another one. This time it was Timmy Williams. If it's not Duvall, if it's not Anderson, it's Williams.
Well, quickly, we get a repeat here. Logan Cook to Cyrus Jones. This time he waits at the 41. Not a particularly high kick, fair catch. Is called for, and a foul that may have been contact.
It's going to be a little Bronx cheer on this one. I can just hear it. Now you see it.
During the kick, lock in the back, receiving team, number 27. 10-yard penalty, committing the kick. First down.
There's Sean Burgess Becker.
There actually was two of them on the play. Tony Brown and Becker, two of them on the same play. Still only 15 yards, even if there's two on the same play.
Thanksgiving special. This is your place.
That's a modern cowbell right over there, by the way. In one hand, you got the iPhone. In the other hand, you got the cowbell.
And this is a famous sketch from Saturday Night Live.
Yeah.
If you don't love cowbells, back up the truck. you save yours from last year?
I think I gave it away to somebody.
Grandkid.
I don't know. No. No, I'm not giving it to the grandkid. God, no.
Well, we could probably arrange 14 of them. Just saying. Darius Stewart has it. Can't stay inbounds. They slipped it to him on the jet sweep, and there's a player down at the 33-yard line.
Stewart, the ball carrier. Out of bounds.
It's Brandon Bryant who has the interception that occurred earlier.
Well, Brandon Bryant is the only freshman on the field for Mississippi State. They lost a lot of veterans from last year's team. But remember, they played a lot of players. A lot of these guys didn't start a year ago, but they played in the football game. Right side of the screen, number 20, right there. Let's see what happens. Oh, it looks like it happens actually as he stretched, just as he stretches out. And that's worrisome for Mississippi State because they've already lost Kendrick Market, their number one safety.
Only had one in excess of three plays, and that resulted in an interception. They've got the ball now at their own 40. They do lead 7-0.
I mean, 45 yards. They've done nothing in this game offensively.
Coker, Ridley, incomplete.
Well, Alabama obviously has a lot of respect for these defensive tackles and inside linebackers for Mississippi State, because the whole game plan has been on the edge. The jet sweeps, finesse, passes. I mean, they are not attacking with the running game at all.
So far, 0 for 5 on third downs. They need 5 here. Blitz, Coker, inside. That's Ridley to the 30. He gets a downfield block and heads in for the touchdown. Ardarius Stewart, number 13, complicated Ridley with the block.
A short pass. A short run turns into a long run when Ardarius Stewart comes back and cleans it up. How about a Stewart there? And there was actually a crackback block as he first turned upfield. Couldn't see who got it, but there was a block that sprung Ridley on the play.
Extra point after the 60-yard pass. That is up and good from Adam Griffiths.
Was an odd look again. Remember when I said the slot was open the play before, nobody was covering?
Right.
It was the same look on this play. No one over the slot. Jay Coker knew where he was going with the ball. Remember, it was just 35 before the pre-snap. And then you give it to Ridley, and he scores.
Calvin Ridley. And Ardarius Stewart hurries in to help. Jacob Coker only 6 of 13 in the ball game, but none bigger than that touchdown pass. Here's the kickoff. It'll go left. Brandon Holloway back across the 10. Kenyon Drake made the tackle, and he's holding his wrist.
At the last play, at the last kickoff of the LSU game, he got dinged and had to go through whether he was even going to play with a slight concussion. But this time he sticks out his right arm, and now he's holding his right wrist. He is really snake bit with the injuries, isn't he? He had a big play on the touchdown, I will say that. First of all, remember the situation. It was third and five. Look at the space that is created. Now, Jake Coker says third and five, really? You're not going to cover Calvin Ridley?
Brandon Bryant is out, and Mac McLaurin, 41, is in. Throw it, but watch number 17 come back and get the block that really springs Ridley, and then our Darius Stewart cleans it up at the end. So everything went wrong for Mississippi State. McLaurin misses the tackle. He's a substitute. Drake gets the block, and then lining up to just give the quarterback an easy throw really was a disaster all the way for Mississippi State.
Another look at the injury.
Injuries just continue to find Kenyon Drake.
First down, 10. Prescott. Out across the 20 to Gabe Miles, number 35.
Now they called him down. Well, they called him down, and whether he was or not, yeah, they're going to call progress right there anyway. Even if he didn't touch the ground, they're going to call forward progress. The whistle blew. That's the right call in that situation.
Gain of 7, second down, 3.
Had the whistle not blown, it would have been a very different circumstance.
Blitz from the corner. Prescott gets around the corner, but not much more. Out to the 29.
And just think about this. You're 0-6 against Alabama. You know they're a good football team. Dan has built a football team, and he knows he's got to get through Alabama. I mean, if you win the West, you got to beat Alabama. They've gotten better, more competitive, but they can't produce points.
There's a pass across the middle. That'll be good for the first down. Fred Ross, number 8.
Let's see if they can continue to chip away here. Dak Prescott so comfortable in the pocket throwing the ball now. Used to be, I used to think he had to be on the run. Now he just can throw it from the pocket.
Oh boy.
Well,
midway through the second quarter, and we've always looking for the opportunity to introduce the duck. And the Aflac trivia question, Dan Mullen has coached 3 of the 6 SEC quarterbacks who produced 100 plus touchdowns. Who are they?
Bang. How about that? Dak Prescott takes on Reggie Ragland that time. I don't want to say he won, but he sure wasn't knocked backwards on the play, but those hits continue to mount up.
Let's get an update from Allen LaForce on Kenyon Drake.
Vernon, Gary, Kenyon Drake just came out of the trainer's tent. He has a huge brace on his entire right arm. They're taking him back to the locker room right now.
Couldn't Lane Kiffin talking to him on the field? He was so delighted with the way Kenyon Drake played last week against LSU.
Third down. Stunts. Down the middle, good. Foot race. Fred Ross. First down, Mississippi State.
They keep Ronnie Harrison to the inside. That's the one spot you can't get beat on. You got no help in the middle, and he beat him right off the line of scrimmage that time. That's a breakdown in the defense. Good route by Ross. Perfect pass.
Now Prescott rolls out under some duress. He throws it away. Ryan Anderson providing the duress and the Verizon red zone this season. How's Dak Prescott done? 21 of 32, 12 touchdowns, and yet to be intercepted. He's only been intercepted once this year. Once in 321 passes. And that was against Kentucky. No flag. Donald Gray, the intended receiver.
Great confidence throw there by Prescott. The windows down here are very tight. He knows he's going to have to throw it over a linebacker's hands, and that ball could have been caught. Ragland goes up, should have been caught, misjudged, and that should have been a touchdown.
Third down, 10.
Got to make the plays when you have the opportunity against Alabama. Because of the substitution, the official made gave Alabama an opportunity to substitute. Alabama declined.
Darunya Wilson near side, three wides to the right. Prescott looking for Wilson, throws it up, and he cannot get up on the ladder. Cyrus Jones, who's 5'10", defending the 6'5", Darunya Wilson.
And they challenge you. One-on-one, bottom of the screen. You got a 6'5" against about a 5'10" corner. But first, one thing that Cyrus Jones knows is he's got help inside. So he went outside shoulder and he played it heavy because he knew inside he had Geno Mateus-Smith sitting there.
Weston Graves 0-for-1. That was from 50. This is from 31. And he has put Mississippi State on the board.
When you have the right call on, and Alabama did, it's easy to play the technique, and they did it.
Coming up, the Geico halftime report on this busy weekend late in the college football season. Back to Adam, Rick, Bryant. Scores and highlights from throughout the country. As the season winds down, the pressure builds, and we all sit in wonder at what the football playoff committee will come up with next.
Well, tell you what, they can capture the headlines for a while,
yes,
can't they?
Yes, they
makes
can.
Tuesday night and Wednesday pretty good radio. We'll say this. Mississippi State, and this is what happens when you have a punt return. Mississippi State has been in the red zone against Alabama twice, have not scored. Alabama has yet to be in the red zone. They've got two touchdowns. 44 plays by Mississippi State, only 20 by Alabama. Would that become a factor as the game goes in to the third and fourth quarter?
Devin Bell will kick off. Richard Mullaney and Damian Harris are back. There's another area where they missed Kenyon Drake. He had returned many of the kickoffs this year, and Harris will let that one go through the end zone. Let's go down to Allie LaForce.
Vern, each home game, a cadet in the Mississippi State University ROTC has the exciting task of firing the cannon. But today they have an honorary cadet. His name is Gabe. He's a 7-year-old boy with a life-threatening illness. He's dealt with a degenerative genetic disorder since birth. Made life extremely difficult, but today those complications, those were secondary to having fun and to celebrating a Mississippi State score with the pull of the cannon. He has a Facebook page. It's called Super Gabe Valentine, where you can follow his progress and show your love and support for him.
Allie, thank you. First down and 10. Dropped. Well, that was a forward pass. And Kenyon Drake has returned to the field, and that doesn't look good. Second down, 10. Up the middle, Derrick Henry.
Looks like, I don't know why he came back out of the field.
I don't either.
But he's going back in the locker room. You could read it all over his face. It's not good news.
Third and 9.
Well, Kenyon, I mean, Derrick Henry, nothing in this game.
6 carries, 14 yards for Henry. Give it to Henry. Watch out.
Jeez.
Watch out. Foot race. And Derrick Henry will win it.
Derrick Henry, the ball carrier.
I'll tell you, this Mississippi State team did not blitz. They only had a three-man line. They played back. They were trying to keep everything in front of them. But when Boniquez Brown tried to come backdoor and make the play, it was over. The man weighs 240 pounds, and he just ran away from the whole defensive secondary from Mississippi State.
15th straight game with a rushing touchdown. That's a 74-yard effort. And just as we were about to establish the non-bona fides.
He hadn't done anything.
Nothing.
And on third and long, they say, Derek, what can you do for us? He said, let me tell you what I can do for you. I can change the scoreboard.
Well, if you like big plays, this is the spot. 74-yard touchdown run. That complements a 69-yard punt return for a touchdown. And it's 21-3.
You know, I'd like to really salute the Alabama offensive line for a key block, but I don't know if there was one. I mean, Mississippi State only had three men up front. They kind of were rushing the passer. And Ryan Kelly had the key block, but I'll show you, he didn't even have to do anything.
Now that's bobbled and picked up. Brandon Holloway. And the touchdown.
Well, here's the look. It's a prevent defense, only three men down. But watch as we break the line of scrimmage here. Ryan Kelly right here. Ryan Kelly really doesn't even need a block on the play. Boniquez Brown goes the wrong direction. He tries to go underneath the play. And then in the secondary, Kevon Coleman, number 11, takes a bad angle. But you know what? A lot of people take bad angles at Henry. He looks so big, and he's going faster than you can think.
Well, he's not small.
No, and he's not slow. It's a big check mark again.
Well, 6'2", 240, he was timed in high school in 11.11 for the 100 meters. And out of Yulee High School, town of 12,000.
Well, it really just takes the breath away from you if you're Mississippi State. You've run 45 plays. Your defense has done a good job. Except for, and that's always a bad thing to say, you know,
mm-hmm.
Mrs. Lincoln, except for, right?
Yeah. Right. Backside hit. The pass is complete. Fred Ross.
You know, usually you say in those situations, well, Manny Diaz played to his MO and he blitzed on the play and he got beat. Not that time. He was playing it safe.
Prescott now 11 of 24. It certainly sounds to Cowboys. Here's Prescott.
You just got to do this drive. If you're Mississippi State, much like the last drive they scored against Alabama last year when they pulled 25-20. If you could just march it down, take your time. If you could go to the locker room 21-10, you got a lot of things good to talk about and maybe points in your last drive. Never easy against this defense, though.
Nope. And again, with a reminder that in college ball, for whatever reason, yardage lost while attempting to pass comes off the rushing yards.
Yeah, even more significance on this drive. And remember, if they give it back to Alabama here, Alabama gets it to start the second half as well.
Right.
Huge drive.
Second and nine.
Well thrown. Well thrown. He really is a great prospect. You know, there's been a lot of quarterbacks. You can name the quarterbacks that have beaten Nick Saban. You know, after that first year, let's give him the first year off. But Tebow, Garcia,
Lee and Jefferson, remember they beat him.
Mm-hmm.
Cam Newton, Lee and Jefferson again. Manziel, Nick Marshall, Bull Wallace, and Chad Kelly. You know, not great names. Tim Tebow is.
Yeah.
Cam Newton is. Three number one picks, by the way. I think Dak has a chance of climbing high in the draft.
Darunya Wilson with this grab, the 6'5 Mr. Basketball from Alabama. He did not start playing organized football till his senior year in high school. Here's Prescott.
Wow, what a throw. Great defense.
That was Tony Brown, number 7.
That ball carried about 35 yards on a bullet, and Tony Brown. Remember I told the story about practice a week ago before LSU, and Nick was riding Tony Brown. Tony, obviously another one of those great athletes that was recruited. He wasn't getting as much playing time, maybe pouting just a little bit in practice. Nick jumped him, motivated him, and look, found his way back on the field.
Tipped at the last second. Intended for Fred Ross, and Reuben Foster made the defensive.
Really thought Fred Ross should come back to the ball here and help his quarterback. Reuben Foster adjusted to the ball. Fred Ross just stood there. If he'd have come back just 2 feet running towards the quarterback, that would have been a completed pass.
Third down, 10.
Technique so important against Alabama. You got to do almost everything right.
From behind, Prescott outruns him and picks up a first down.
Well, I'll tell you, Ryan Anderson came around one side to put the pressure on, and then Timmy Williams is chasing Prescott from behind. I think that's a good play. The crowd is reacting. But Dak Prescott could have just as easily kept running and turned up. You got to corral this guy. And then Raglan and Prescott bump.
Gain of 17. A'shaun Robinson. That's 5 tackles for Ross Robinson.
That's, I think, the 5th sack of the game already. Wow.
That is right. Loss of 5, 2nd and 15. That one got next up by Cyrus Jones, number 5.
You know, we talked about the Alabama defensive backs taking on the blockers. Cyrus Jones has a punt return. He has a great knockdown on the fade pass. Watch him take on the blocker here. Knocks his guy back into it. If it was basketball, he could have got a taunting.
That's right. Third down, 13. Prescott.
Interesting call. Interesting call. I mean, it clearly can't be a field goal coming up. Alabama will keep their defense on the field. You don't want to give.
Clock continues to unwind.
Yeah,
now
surprise. No timeouts being used. Boy, I don't know it. You haven't scored a lot of points. You're going to go in at halftime with basically all 3 timeouts. Very surprised with the strategy.
Prescott, yeah. That's a dismal ending for Mississippi State.
Can't play safe. You got to go for the kill against these guys. You got a senior quarterback. You've lived through all the mistakes of a 2- or 3-year career. Not using those timeouts here. A third down call of a quarterback draw. I'm very surprised.
Ryan Anderson got the sack on 4th down. Yeah. Ball goes over with 15 seconds to go. Well, let's get the duck back on and give you the answer. Dan Mullen has coached 3 of the 6 SEC quarterbacks who produced 100 plus. Tim Tebow, I bet you all got that one. Chris Leak.
I would not have guessed Chris Leak.
Nope. And, of course, Dak Prescott. Again, Gary's reminder that Alabama will get the ball to open the third quarter. There's a flag down.
Holding on the offense, number 50. 10-yard penalty for the previous spot. It's his first down.
It's on Alphonse Taylor.
Fourth down play on the opening drive. They get stopped.
Mm-hmm.
Get it in the red zone again. They can't convert. And two big plays. Well, three big plays, really, right? Punt
yes.
return. Short pass on third and five. I thought misaligned. And then again on third down, a running play right up the middle that dashes you for a touchdown. Shocking.
Alabama leads it.
For a chance to win $1,000 and two tickets to this year's Egg Bowl. If successful, $1,000 off.
And it's good to have Allie, who is with Dan Mullen.
Coach, you held Alabama to just five first downs, but it was the three big plays of over 50 yards each that has made this a lopsided
first
half.
You can't do that. It's horrendous right there. I mean, we got two misalignments. We don't tackle anybody on defense on the long touchdown run after just completely shutting them down the whole first half. You know, then we don't score in the red zone. All the little things you got to do to win, we're not doing out here.
It seemed like you weren't happy with the officials. What's bothering you?
I don't know. They're just laying on our quarterback right there in the last play. We're trying to go 2 minutes. I don't know. I was just asking them why they didn't stop the clock or do something since they wouldn't get off the quarterback on the ground. That was all.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
There you go.
Guy lost his cowbell. That's the end of the first half, 21-3. Let's go to Adam Zucker in our New York studio.
To Iraq and served 5 years as psychological operations specialist in the U.S. Army. He's currently
AT&T. Boya. And by Chick-fil-A.
We are back in Starkville getting set for the start of the second half, 21-3. One of the negatives for Alabama in the first half, this injury to Kenyon Drake, number 17. Obviously a forearm injury or an elbow. And a moment ago, Allie with Nick.
Coach, we saw Kenyon Drake leave the first half with a big brace on his right arm. What's his injury, and how does that affect this offense?
Well, he's out for this game for sure. We're going to do x-rays, but I think he's got a broken arm.
You had the three big plays in the first half, but outside of that, just 46 yards on offense. How do you move the ball more consistently?
Well, we got to do a better job of blocking him up front. We've dropped a lot of balls. We just got to execute better. We're just not executing like we need to control the football.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Tough to see. Injuries have been so much a part of Kenyon Drake's career. No need to say much, is there? You can't?
It's right there.
It is a part of football at Mississippi State University.
Yeah, I almost feel like it's false enthusiasm right now. I think they're trying to get charged up, but right now I don't think the Mississippi State fans really believe.
Mm-hmm.
They need something from their team to really ratchet it up a little bit.
Well, they got a little bit of a break on that kickoff because the ball is out of bounds, so it'll come this way. What do you think they need?
I think they get, you know, the one chance they have is they've run a lot of plays. Alabama's only run 23 plays, over 50 for Mississippi State. So I think if they could put one on the board here in the third quarter and get it into the fourth quarter, maybe they could wear down Alabama. But that's not easy because Alabama plays a lot of players. But their only hope is to continue to think that Alabama will struggle, put something on the board, and try to get this crowd believing more than I think they really believe. We used to call it false chatter. You know, I mean, really, you really believe because it doesn't feel like it.
Yep. Alabama out of the spread. Damian Williams goes in motion. Derrick Henry, a couple most of the afternoon has been like that.
Yep.
Beniquas Brown makes the tackle.
Well, Alabama, you know, had 23 plays in 8 possessions. So 3 times 8 is 24. Well, they didn't have 8 3 and outs, but they had less plays than 3 and outs. It been big plays. You know, 2 of them, of their 180 yards, 2 of them were 134 of their 180 yards.
Second down, 10. Reverse, Ardarius Stewart gets around the corner and might have enough for a first down. Let's go through halftime trends.
Well, Dak Prescott was harassed. I mean, when you get sacked 6 times, not only are those 6 negative plays, but it produces other plays because you just don't feel the timing. Derrick Henry, 1 big run, but 3 huge plays. That's been the difference.
On 3rd and 1, Henry bounces to the outside and then is able to move the chain.
Nothing was there. He made that happen himself. One dodge, 2 dodge, and basically barely got it back to the line of scrimmage.
Nine for 91, as you saw in the graphic, but the second line affected so much by a 74-yard touchdown run. Play action. Coker Chase gets rid of it. Damian Harris.
Well, Damian Harris is obviously playing the Kenyon Drake role now. A second back in the game, going to do all the motions and find those short passes to the outside. The game plan is the game plan for Alabama. They're not really attacking between the tackles. They're trying to finesse the ball on the outside and look for big plays, and it's worked.
They'll come this way with Ardarius Stewart. Missed tackle.
Nice block by Mullaney that time. The Alabama role players continue to make plays. Remember on the touchdown run, it was Kenyon Drake. This time, Richard Mullaney gets the block inside, and then another missed tackle from the secondary. Bryant, number 20, injured earlier, comes and can't make the play.
Ardarius Stewart, 2-yard gain. Beniquas Brown, number 42. We have called his name a lot today.
And the one time he didn't want his name called,
yes,
I thought was a key play. He tried to backdoor a run by Henry, and it was really the difference in the play.
Second and 8.
Boy, 10 men at the line of scrimmage.
Henry gets kick out walk, but that same man comes back. Brandon Bryant, number 20, fought off the block and made the tackle.
I think Dan Mullen has told Manny Diaz, we can't give up any more points. Because look at this defense. All 10, all 11 Mississippi State players are at the line of scrimmage. They don't even want to give up a field goal here.
Third and six.
Will they blitz him again? There's that three-man line that was gashed before.
Ridley joins two others on the near side. They fake the screen. Now they fire it. Ridley inside move. Short of the first down.
Good coverage that time by the state secondary. Alabama tried to gimmick him with a hook and go, and it was covered to the outside.
And you saw number 99. That was Jamal Peters. He's wearing the uniform of his fallen teammate, Keith Joseph. We mentioned him at halftime. Adam Griffith is on for a 42-yarder. Career long last week, 55 yards. After a shaky start to the season, Adam Griffith is having a fine finish. Opening drive, third quarter.
Well, how about that? Alabama's best drive. And they didn't score. Only three instead of seven.
Parkville Monday, an all-new Supergirl takes flight in a new episode of the hit drama Monday at 8, 7 Central, only CBS. And let's check in with Allie LaForce.
Thank you, Vern. I was told by Alabama that Minka Fitzpatrick has a lower extremity. He's out for the game. On Mississippi State's side, Boniquez Brown had some sort of injury in his knee. The athletic training staff pushed on it. He gave them the thumbs up, so they rubbed an ointment on it, and he looks to be fine to go back in.
All right. Thank you, Allie. Griffith will kick it off for the Crimson Tide. Winners of seven in succession in this series. Brandon Holloway. Bradley Sill with the tackle. Well, Dak Prescott opted to come back and work on his passing.
He did. He did. He said he needed to get better at a lot of things in the offseason. He went to Coach Mullen and said, I want to work on my footwork. I want to get better in the pocket, being able to throw on balance and off balance, find a consistent arm position, and do it with anticipation. I think he has done that. He's a much better throwing quarterback. But there's more than just the physical side of being a quarterback. You know, when you're doing a lot of good things, you have to process that information quicker than he did in the past. Because of that, you get a bigger playbook, more opportunities to throw it. You know, he's been through the SEC, seen it all, done it all. Nothing surprises him this year. And finally, nothing to prove but Alabama. And that's a tough one. That's a big check mark.
Yes. Well, his team is down 24-3, and that one is almost picked off. Almost more than anyone I think any of us can remember, he is the face of athletics at Mississippi State University, and it's a role he welcomes and handles with such grace. He was chatting with Scott Strickland, the athletic director. I said, give me an adjective. He said, wholesome.
Not bad.
Nope. Out of the backfield. This is good. Down the sideline. Brandon Holloway.
See how quickly he processed the information on this play. Obviously, that's not his first target. Looks left, looks right, realizes that Alabama has bailed on that, dumps it to his back for a first down. When you're a passing quarterback, that's how you have to attack the defense. Make them cover all five of your receivers. Tony Brown in the Minka Fitzpatrick spot right now in this game. Hold on, what was that, a running play?
All the way Did I catch just a smidge of sarcasm there?
I mean, compared to last week, where we go, was that a pass? We go, okay, what was this? But no movement.
Nope.
You get Gus Wally coming in there trying to move out those linebackers. It's just not happening. And that's why they're running the spread and finessing it. They can't run downhill against Alabama.
Prescott got him at the 40.
Where the ball was bounced, I thought it was bounced a couple times, but at the end, Freddie Brown ended up with it. Breaking out, Ragland's on the play, sticks his hands up, but he corrals him.
Yeah.
Look at it, see it bobbled just before T.S. Smith got there.
That's a gain of 19. Play fake into the flat behind Holloway, but he's able to grab hold and gets a couple of yards. Number 10 on number 10. Reuben Foster with help from number 24, Geno Matias Smith.
I'll tell you, it's really tough to tempo Alabama and make them tired. Now, you may be able to tempo them and get them out of position with lineups, but to get them tired is very difficult. They substitute so quickly, and they are so deep.
Yeah, they've got a few elephants in that defensive line. Oh, boy. And they've got Reggie Ragland at linebacker.
Talking about deep, this scene from last week's game with LSU, 19 players are on the field ready to adjust to whatever LSU does. Once they see the formation, boom, like a machine. And 11 end up for Kirby Smart's defense.
Kirby Smart, defensive coordinator for the Alabama Crimson Tide. Four-man rush. Prescott, watch out. Tim Williams, number 56.
That ball came out. That's live. That ball is live.
It sure is. And it's DJ Petway who's going to stroll in.
Will he make it? Just at the end of the play.
That was close to a Leon Lett.
Well, I didn't mind the player trying to make the play at all here at the end of it. Ball's free. Is he down? Oh, it might be brought back. I think his knee may be down. Alabama thought his knee was down, but there was no whistle.
The field, the ball was fumbled and recovered by the defense. The previous play is under review.
All right, here we go.
Let's see if the ball's loose. He's controlling it, knees down.
Knees down.
I think that's coming back. The interesting part is at the end of the play, because it was a post touchdown that wasn't a touchdown flag.
Right.
Will there be a flag on the play? Remember, the original call will be a sack against Mississippi State. Even Alabama believes this ball is coming back. Everybody's lining up at the spot of the foul. You know, I don't mind Donald Gray making a play on this. Donald Gray, number 6, is going, maybe I can get to him, and shoves him just as he crosses the line. I didn't think that really should have been called. It was right as he was crossing the line. He was hoping to get a turnover, and they get a flag, but it's a dead ball flag. Whatever that means. I don't think Petway believed this was even a live play. He goes, I'm not wasting my energy on this.
But here comes Gray.
Yep. And just as he crosses, he shoves him. Come on. I don't think so either. I wouldn't throw a flag on that. There's no way I'd throw a flag. I've seen less things happen in my liver than that.
Well, if you just give the grandsons Krispy Kremes,
right,
they wouldn't react like that.
That's not that bad. Come on. I don't think it was that bad what happened. But it was called. Right now, Nick says, I don't care about the flag. I just want the sack where it happened. That's all I care about. we're hearing down from the truck, Vern, that that dead ball foul will stand and they'll march off an additional 15 yards. It's a cheap 15, I'll say that. But it wasn't a touchdown. On the other hand, it wasn't sick. Yeah.
Ken Williamson, the referee.
After further review, the runner was down, trying to lose possession of the ball. During the play after that, there was an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty against number six, Mississippi State. That penalty will be enforced, 15 yards. It'll be fourth down.
Well, this is the rough, tough SEC, and just as Petway crosses the line, technically, come on. Technically, Vern finishes that.
Well, I doubt.
Technically, yeah, but, it's a penalty, I guess.
Yeah, well,
please.
His right foot
please.
Was down in the end zone.
Yeah, I guess.
You know me. I'm very legalistic.
Yes, you are.
I've got a reputation for that. A rule is a rule.
I know.
It was iffy.
Well, it was a great play by the Alabama defense to get the sack in the first place. Timmy Williams, I mean, this, I'll tell you, the difference in this Alabama defense, they can rush the passer this year, and they do it in waves. I mean, one time you're looking, I said it before, 30, 22, 56, Duvall, Anderson, and Williams are monsters coming off the edge.
Well, we saw how this front seven limited Fournette last week.
Vern, why don't you start a hashtag, should that have been called? Go ahead, start it.
You want me to start?
Start a hashtag, should that have been called?
Does that involve tweeting?
I don't even know what it means. Whoa.
And after all that, oh, I get a vision of me on Twitter.
There's rules. 24-3, you get to do stuff that you don't do in touch.
Is that right?
Yes.
Oh, I can't wait for Instagram. Sponsored by Ford. Verizon. Wheels Up. And by Chick-fil-A. Those gorgeous sunset pictures. Aerial coverage provided by Goodyear. For 60 years, Goodyear has provided aerial coverage of college football's greatest traditions and biggest rivalries. Alabama, Mississippi State. These two schools, by the way, separated by only 83 miles and the state line. So Alabama bust over from Tuscaloosa last night, and they did stay in the nearby town of Columbus.
Can there be any more contrast between two schools so close in proximity yet so far apart in the history of college football?
No, I don't think so.
I mean, it's Alaska, Florida, isn't it?
Yeah.
Good defense.
Calvin Ridley. Well, top 10 today. Clemson leading. Alabama's leading in this one. Ohio State won again. Notre Dame over Wake Forest.
The Iowa-Oklahoma State game is the key one.
Yes.
That's the one that everybody's looking at right now.
24-21 right now. And then Arkansas at LSU.
Look how wide this split is down here at the bottom. Is he getting different looking split?
Derrick Henry.
They're hoping. The fans are hoping. They're not buying yet, but they're hoping. Isn't that a polite cowbell? That's a polite cowbell. That's.
I agree.
Right. That means we brought him. We might as well shake him.
Third and eight. Coker. Stewart.
Nice defense.
Yep.
your guy again makes the tackle. Anquez Brown, he reads him so fast, gets there and makes the tackle. A little help from the secondary that time by Bryant. Well defended, and chance to do something again. Chance to get the crowd in the game.
That brings on J.K. Scott. This will be his fifth punt of the night.
Mississippi State create a big play on their punt return team. They're going to go for the block.
Fred Ross is back. Fair catch. Taken at the 24. 47-yard punt. Mississippi State Bulldogs need a spark. 24-3 Alabama. Many great traditions abound on game day throughout the league. And each week we'll give you a taste of tradition presented by Sonic. For more, here's Allie.
Thank you, Vern. Mississippi State, they can trace the roots of its Bulldog mascot back to 1935 when they played Frank Thomas's Alabama squad in Tuscaloosa. The week of the game, then coach Major Ralph Sass decided the team needed a live Bulldog mascot. So he went up to Memphis, came back to Starkville with a Bulldog named Ptolemy. With Ptolemy on the sidelines, the Bulldogs beat the Tide 20-7. Ptolemy's litter mate named Bully took over the mascot's duties later that year, and since then 20 other Bulldogs have earned the title of Bully, including Bully 21, who's looking to bring that same magic to today's game as his forefather did 80 years ago. Vern?
Ptolemy. That's a great name for a mascot, don't you think? Or Bully. Or Ugga. First down and 10. Prescott.
Oh, beautiful throw. Well, yep. Covered by Ragland, too.
Fred Ross.
This is basically the philosophy of the Alabama defense. Obviously, they got big check marks going from the beginning of the game, but they force you to throw the ball accurately. If you can, there's opportunities, but they force you to do it over and over and over again.
Prescott's got it for the first down. He is scissored as he gets in the air. And that is a Mississippi State first down.
I'll tell you what, he physically is paying the price in this game. He is the running attack. He is the passing attack. He's the leader of the team.
He'll run it again.
Oh, slide. Oh, a slide. Of course, he's way bigger than Humphrey on that play.
Yep.
It's like Humphrey said, can I slide here? Because Prescott comes and goes, no. Woo. You know, I think of all the quarterbacks that Alabama has faced and the games they have lost, we went through the list. I think Prescott most closely plays like Cam Newton.
Funny you should mention. Here's a nice run. Ross out of bounds at the 31-yard line.
Nice little deceptive play here. Dak Prescott looks to his left, comebacks to the right. Good block downfield, and boy, nice job by Wilson not getting the holding penalty. Gotta score. Gotta score. Four down territory.
Gets it complete to Ross again. Oh, Donald Gray.
I'll tell you what, I like Donald Gray. You know, was his knee down is the only question I had when he caught the pass. Donald Gray has played a really strong football game. Junior college transfer. He had that penalty. We'll call it a penalty since they marched off 15. But he has played hard. Remember, he had the long catch down the sideline.
Mm-hmm. Prescott.
Here it is again.
Wally, the tight end. First and goal at the 6.
Prescott has some skills. I'll tell you, he's going to go high in the draft. When you can throw the ball like this, look at that coverage. Couldn't put it anywhere else to complete that ball, and he did it.
7 straight completions now.
Hamilton was all over rolling on that play. 4 down territory, I guarantee you.
Oops.
Prior to snap, false start. Offense number six.
Boy.
5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
Drive killer.
Think about it. Mississippi State, this 0-6 Dan Mullen is against this Alabama team. There have been some mistakes, and a lot of them, as you can see the motion right there. Donald Gray, 6-0-6. He's only scored 48 points total in six games. Tonight, only three. Alabama's averaging 28 a game against them.
Prescott. It'll be second down. Jonathan Allen got him here.
You know, Vernon, it's not like Alabama scored 60 in one game and 10 the next. If you look at the six games, Alabama's been very consistent. 31, 30, 24, 38, 20, and 25. You have to score points against this team. You don't have a chance. You know Alabama's going to put at least 24 points on the board.
As they have in this one. Watch out from the backside.
Ball's out again.
Ball's out. Jonathan Allen's second consecutive play. That's eight sacks for the night.
Wow. Oh. Rufus Warren was beat cleanly, and Allen is showing to you why a lot of people believe he may be the first defensive lineman in this league taken, and there are some good ones in this league.
Into the end zone. Too far.
I think Mississippi State has to go field goal here. If they were down inside the 5 or 10 yard line, they could go for it at fourth downs. But not now. The sack and the penalty. Look at this throw. Dak goes right down the middle with it. He's got an opportunity, but it had to be perfect. We talked about it. You got to throw the ball perfect, and that one was not. And Freddie Ross had a chance, but just a foot too high.
That will bring on Weston Graves from 39 yards out. Well, they got something out of it.
Yes, they did.
Dak Prescott got his team into a first and goal. They had to settle for a field goal try. All right, Adam, thank you. Tonight on CBS, we'll begin with a special 48 hours and we'll concentrate on coverage of the Paris attacks, followed by the CBS Democratic presidential debate tonight, only CBS. .124 to go in the third. 24-6. Devin Bell will kick off, and it is a good one. Well, why don't we talk about your interpretation?
Well, remember a year ago?
Yes.
We got a lot of trouble this calling it. We know stinking committee. But a year ago, I said these teams were in if they won out. A year, 53 weeks ago today.
Okay.
Alabama, Florida State, and Oregon won out. Well, today we still don't need a committee. If the Big Ten champ, Ohio State or Iowa, wins out, they're in. Clemson, if they win out, they're in. Baylor, if they win out, or Oklahoma State. And the SEC one-loss champ is there. Michigan State, I still think, controls their own destiny. I think the Big Ten one-loss champ will be in if it's Michigan State. Now, Vern, if I was on that committee,
yes,
I would hand that in. Right the way it is. I'd go, and then I'd go to Barry Alvarez, Barry, let's go play golf. I'd bring Condoleezza Rice because she belongs to Augusta, just in case, okay? And then I'd bring Jeff Long because he looks so sad on Tuesday nights, and Barry's a lot of fun to play golf with. I'll tell you that right now.
Okay.
And then I'd hand that in and say, call me when it changes.
That would cut out a lot of film that you...
That's right. You don't need to do anything. Yeah. Let's go play golf. I know Barry would go. I think Barry would go.
As long as that Big Ten team is in.
Until that changes, nothing else matters.
Henry has gone over 100, helped in no small part by a 74-yard touchdown run in the first half. Final 19 seconds, third quarter. Most of the night has been like that.
Richie Brown, I think, is the guy who got that one. Right there, Richie Brown. Watch him make the play. You visited with Richie. Boom! One-on-one, gets a little help from behind. And they get the stop. It's very close. Did they get the first down or not? It was real close. Did they mark first down or not? I was doing the replay.
Well, that's the fourth quarter indication. The drama will continue. We'll find out shortly. That's the end of three. Back to Starco after this message and a word from your local station. Now he's got an angle, and it's a foot race to the corner. Touchdown, Alabama. Give it to Henry. Watch out. Watch. And we're back live on first down. It's Henry again going left. And on first down, he picks up about 8 yards.
Obviously, they got the first down on the one before, right?
Yes, very perspective.
Well, you know, we went through this, Vern, all the little things that Mississippi State had to do. I think two things have stood out for me. No help for Dak Prescott, no running back, and the defensive line talent has been on the big check instead of the other check. 8 sacks. Dak Prescott in his career has never been sacked more than 3 times. A big difference in the game, and obviously the big plays by Alabama. They're really, really good. They're really good.
Well, 3 plays in excess of 50 yards, and they lead it 24-6.
Alabama's had 9 sacks, 3 big plays for touchdowns. Mississippi State has been in the red zone 3 times, 2 field goals.
Third and 2. Henry. Tackled by Brandon Bryant, number 20.
Well, this is back-to-back first downs on third down and short. Last time it was a little closer, but both times downhill. You know, the interesting thing again about this Alabama team, if you didn't watch last week's game, they really don't have a fullback on the team.
Right.
So in these short yardage situations, they have to do a little different type of attack. But both of those were dead downhill.
And we slipped. Well, the end drive last week was brilliantly conceived.
Yeah, as it happened, LSU had pulled within 14. And then the kickoff goes down inside the 10-yard line. And all Alabama did was finish the game on offense. I thought that was the biggest pressurized game. They're not going to probably finish the game on offense on this drive, but they're surely trying to shorten the game now. Remember, Mississippi State has 74 plays to 35 or 6 going into the fourth quarter. They want to give their
defense a rest.
Here's the flip out to O.J. Howard. That's his first catch tonight.
This was a busted play. Either the quarterback or the running back went the wrong way. There was no play action pass, but once it was dumped off, one missed tackle, and they're into the secondary for another first down. I think it was Zach Jackson, number 14, that missed the tackle.
First down at the 40.
The odd part about Alabama having big plays is they have not had big plays in the passing game. In the last three games, you know, Jake Coker's been accurate, but he's only had six plus 20-yard passes in the last three games.
Out on the left side, it's Calvin Ridley.
Just to reemphasize, as we watch that pass to Ridley, Jake in the last three games has gone 58 for 76, 76%, but just six of them were for 20 yards or more. Two to Stewart, two to Ridley, one to Drake, and one to Howard. Now, they've added a couple more today.
Yeah, that yes. Well, he had gone through a dearth of touchdown passes
right
in previous games, and he had the big one to Ridley earlier in this game. Getting a little...
Well, I do think this Alabama team, Vern, is the one team that can beat you so many different ways. It's kind of been the theme watching them through this whole great run that Nick Saban has built here at Alabama from 2008 on. They beat you five different ways. Which one you want to choose?
Henry, still upright.
Yeah, I thought that play was defended and he ran right through it. I don't even know if it was blocked correctly. He comes off the edge. Someone's standing right there to make the tackle, and he runs through two tackles again. I think that time it was Richie Brown, 39, that had the angle and misjudged it.
There's Richie Brown, only married member of the Mississippi State team, and his family, like so many others, so affected by Hurricane Katrina. They were away from their home for better than 6 months. Here is a pass almost intercepted. Now, Richie Brown, there are occasions when you meet these young student athletes and you just go, gosh, here's a young man, Richie Brown. First of all, he's worn a beard since he was 16. I mean, many of us couldn't even think about that till we were 21. He's married. He's a tightrope walker, and he plays classical piano. To say he's a man of diverse interests is to say, you know, there's some good ones in college football.
Carney picks those holes.
Now he's got, as if I understand all this, Fear the Beard, a Twitter account.
I don't know if he did it, but we did meet his wife last night. I asked her, have you ever seen Richie without a beard? She paused. Nope. Never seen him without a beard.
Well, and one more. Richie told us this story. When Coach Mullen came to recruit him, they walked into the locker room, and Mullen said to Richie Brown, hey, Coach, have you met Richie Brown? Oh, gosh.
Nothing there.
Nope.
The defense.
Allie, help us out. Coker, a little slow getting up. Hit by JT Gray and Richie Brown. Richie Brown wearing number 39. And let's go down to Allie.
Vern, just to add to the beard conversation, we asked Richie, what's the deal with the beard Twitter account? He said, I don't know. I certainly didn't start it. He said, I've been told that it's just one of the students here, a fan on campus. I know nothing about it. So there's somebody out there that loves his beard that much, they created their own account for it.
Blocked.
Blocked. Griffith. So Cleveland. Number seven.
Was it seven or was it inside? Yes, it was early. Cleveland, I thought it was going to be inside by Chris Jones, but he got it before Jones got it. Nice play.
Well, we had a scoreless first quarter, led in large part by plays like this. This was Prescott, stopped short. A first quarter goal line stand by the Crimson Tide, and then this punt return became the first of three touchdowns in excess of 50 yards. This was Ridley, Cyrus Jones with the punt return, Ridley with another one, and then he had been so quiet, had Derrick Henry, but not for long. 74 yards, and tough news for Alabama. Their running back, Kenyon Drake, apparently, according to Nick Saban, broke his right arm on that kickoff coverage. And Dak Prescott has gone down 9 times. That is a career high. Now, Coker.
Yeah, he got hit on that last pass play, and they were reaching under his, I thought it was his right shoulder. And Allie's going to get into that tent today. I'm pretty sure she'll get it. Just ask Nick. Nick will let her in, don't you think?
Yeah.
I think not.
This is Brandon Holloway.
Holloway, the ball carrier.
Well, they have not allowed a touchdown in the fourth quarter thus far this year. They've only allowed 12 points in the fourth quarter. But first, they need to score.
Yes.
And that's not helpful. Tony Brown defending.
Well, the thing is, Mika Fitzpatrick goes down for an injury, so they bring in another 5-star corner, Tony Brown. You know, that last drive by Alabama was 7 minutes, 6 minutes, 57 seconds. They did not get any points, but it was effective. With all the plays Mississippi State had, that defense really needed a blow.
Here's Prescott. Incomplete. And
yeah, what do you do? Fourth and four.
One of the managers went down. What do you think?
I think you got to go for it, don't you? And there's 9 minutes left.
Well, Cyrus Jones is back at the 40 in case the punt. Here's Coker back. Cooper Bateman was warming up just a moment ago. No?
Oh, I'd go for it. Yep. Maybe they got a fake punt. Alabama's playing defense safe.
That's not a good punt. But it's going to wind up being just fine.
Only problem is Alabama probably is going to take another 2 or 3 minutes off, even if the drive doesn't work. I don't quite get it.
Jacob Coker coming back on the field. Alabama has the ball again. CBS is sponsored by Aflac. Ram Trucks. New York Life. And by Kay Jewelers. Aerial coverage provided by Goodyear for 60 years. Goodyear has provided aerial coverage of college football's greatest traditions and biggest rivalries. We're in the fourth quarter. 8:51 remaining, 24-6. And Jake Coker is back at quarterback.
Magic tent comes through again. What goes on? This music fits the tent, by the way, too. What goes on in the tent?
First down, 10. Bit of a high snap. Watch out.
Whoa.
Oh, so close. Brandon Bryant, number 20.
Brandon Bryant was injured on the one long run, was not in the game. It would have been nice to get a tackle just like that, or it wouldn't have been a big long touchdown run.
Now here's nice winder. Here's Bryant.
He's good to watch. He had a great game against LSU.
Yes. Nice winder's number 46. Henry, stiff arm.
Oh my goodness.
How do you like that?
I thought number 11, Kevon Coleman, had the angle easily on Henry, and he ripped right through, reminded me of Eric Dickerson right there.
65 yards.
Watch him turn. Now watch number 11. He's got the angle. And Derrick Henry, can you spell Heisman? Right there with the straight arm. Holy cow.
Well, he's got 204 yards in this one. That's the third game this year in which he's exceeded 200 yards. Well,
Brian, remember the run by Cam Newton where he broke away from Patrick Peterson?
Yep.
It reminded me of this run. We can get the safety in the play. No, you really can't see it, but I thought number 11, Coleman, had the angle, and he just runs right by him. My goodness. 240 pounds.
And teammates. Derrick Henry on the left, Kenyon Drake on the right, and I'm sure they're talking about that run that we just saw.
Just watch the angle on this play. Coleman right here has got his guy right on Henry, and then Ridley has a good block as well. Watch this, but watch the acceleration. I think he's got the angle right there. He takes it, wrong angle. My goodness.
Well, Dan Mullen watching. Gosh, I wish we had that guy.
I think that is what you call a big check mark right there, right?
Yeah, it sure is. Well, Kevon Coleman thought he had a shot at him. That didn't work out so well. It was Griffith was the kick. And you mentioned the name from Southern Methodist University.
Yeah, somebody asked me, what does Henry remind you in the secondary? And I said he has the high cut of Eric Dickerson. When he starts stepping upfield, remember Dickerson was able to carry a lot when there's 2,000 yards. But there's the sprint, and there's the acceleration. That's who I'd most compare him to. Eric Dickerson was 6'3", 220. Derrick Henry, 6'3", 242.
Yes. Here's the flip out left side for Mississippi State. That's Fred Ross. He's had a busy day today. Well, you saw the mention of the three 200-yard games. The last time we saw him, a week ago, Derrick Henry carried it 38 times for 210 against LSU. Earlier, we watched him carry it 32 times for 236. That was at Texas A&M.
Well, there's no doubt. Yeah, another interception. Or an interception, I mean.
Yeah, that's the first one. Marlon Humphrey. That's Dak Prescott's first interception of the season.
You know what? This shows me a lot, though, in Dak. Now you got to fit it in. I mean, do you have enough guts to make the tough throw? And here he tries to make the tough throw between the zones. Anybody can dump the ball off and go home and get completions. But here he tries to go downfield and make a play. That says a lot to me about Dak Prescott.
Well, let me quickly correct. He did have an interception against Kentucky. That's only his second of the season. Starkville, Gary Danielson, let's take a look at our AT&T strong performance.
Well, the game has been dominated by the front seven of Alabama. Their defensive line has been too much. They knew that Dak Prescott was the guy. They did it a week ago against Leonard Fournette. They did it a different way this week. How about the versatility of that defensive line? 1 week,
They held Fournette to 31 yards rushing. The very next week, the very same guys come back with 9 sacks.
And on the sidelines at the end of the last play, the outstanding wide receiver, Darunya Wilson, on his back. Not sure what happened.
He's the one that had the hit on the play right at the end of it. Now, did his head get bent sideways? That's always the fear.
Oh, the medical staff at Mississippi State.
And that's Dan Mullen looking over in the white coat as well.
Right. Take one more look, see if we can determine what might have happened.
I thought he sprung his neck a little bit on this play as he hit him. See how his head concusses with the elbow right there on the shoulder, and he bent it to the side. I think that's the play right there. That's the injury. Hopefully he just went numb for a couple seconds and he's fine, but they have to take extreme caution in the situation.
We will step aside. All right, Adam, thank you. They are still tending to Darunya Wilson. Cart has come out, and he is in a sitting position.
I think that's good that he's sitting up. They would not do that if there was a serious spine injury or neck injury like that. They'd take him off a different way. So perhaps a bit of good news, long term at least.
Mm-hmm. Well, Mississippi State fans expressing concern, as you can tell. Nick Saban came over, standing next to Dan Mullen. Okay, they're going to try and move some of the players out, and Nick Saban will make his way out of the picture.
You know, excuse me, for Vern, for Georgia and Mark Richt, since the world was ending, as we look at, going to peek at the Eastern standings, Florida obviously has won. That's over. They're going to be in the championship, but they want to get there just with one loss, still have Florida State in front of them. But how about Georgia answering? And that means that Alabama just has a wounded Auburn team that they're going to have standing in the way for them now.
Yes, that's right. They will finish the season in the Iron Bowl in Auburn. They have a game scheduled against Charleston Southern. I haven't even looked, but I'm sure that's homecoming. And then they go down to Auburn. Alabama about to win this.
Next week we'll be at the LSU Ole Miss matchup. The winner of that game, if it's LSU, will be praying for Auburn. Auburn to knock off Alabama.
Let's go to Allie LaForce.
I do have a little bit of an injury update. He hasn't moved hardly at all, but they just recently tickled his leg and he was able to move his foot. It was really the first movement that we've seen since he's been down. Of course, members of both teams giving support. They're raising him up right now. Derrick Henry said, "We're praying for you." Nick Saban standing by and everybody just cheering and standing up on their feet as he rises to his.
Well, the understandably concerned fans remain attentive in the stands.
Yep, that's good news.
Sure is.
These players risk their careers and sometimes even their life on any play in playing football like that, and that was a dangerous one. Now as I look out on the field, I better not see Derrick Henry. He's got his over 200 yards. Remember, Kenyon Drake has been injured. I think it's now time to give Damian Harris a few carries and get another back ready for the Iron Bowl. Remember, they've got a game in between that they can feature Damian Harris, but Henry doesn't need any more carries in this game. Really want to talk and salute Lane Kiffin and Kirby Smart, two of our great assistant coaches we have in college football. Let's start with Lane a little bit, Vern. You know, I really, you know, all the stuff that's happened to Lane, you know, his past and always is brought up. I think he's learned a lot from Nick Saban. We were talking to him a couple weeks ago. What has Lane learned? He says, you know, he's a brilliant guy. He's got a great mind. He can call plays, but he's learned to coach everybody now. He's learned to bring everybody along, and you can't argue with the success he's had with this Alabama team. And Kirby Smart, as we watch Wilson go off the field to the crowd cheering, I think Kirby Smart is one of the best college football coaches we have in this game, and he's ready to get a head coaching job as well. Better to go upright like that, isn't it? Boy.
Well, we all wish him well. He's got the good thoughts of everyone here and all those watching. Darunya Wilson.
Yeah. Scary, scary things.
See on the left, Bill Martin, the outstanding sports information director here at Mississippi State, who will follow the cart in or not come this way. And we're back to play. Still 7-11 to go, and
looks
Damian
like we
Harris.
Got, and Cooper Bateman's in the game too at quarterback.
Yep. Here's the toss. Harris. That's a first down play.
Damian Harris, the ball carrier.
Pretty much changes all across that offensive line now.
Just, no gain on the play.
The only way Henry gets in there is if he sneaks it. There's no way they're going to let him in.
Or if they decide to use him on punt coverage.
How far? Yes, exactly. How far do you think Jay Coker has come since the beginning of this year?
Oh, my gosh.
To right now. Vern told the story about him not starting that Ole Miss game. That really was the turning point for him.
Well, they started Cooper Bateman, and Bo Scarborough is in right now, number nine. That's only his third carry of the year.
Yeah.
There's Jacob Coker, and he told us, remember how he got, I'm going to use him, he got irritated.
He did.
When he didn't start, and he came on, and really, by the nature of his play in that loss to Ole Miss, grabbed control of his
he did, and I thought the A&M game was huge for him. When he started running and playing physical, he really won the team over. Well, Scarborough is also important because of an injury. We've seen it with these running backs. It can be any play. They're going to need somebody else as well. Scarborough, a very highly thought of back who's been injured, now starting to get healthy.
Here's Damian Harris, number 34. Well, Gary's mentioned the fact that our SEC on CBS gang will head to Oxford, Faulkner country. And we'll have LSU at Ole Miss, 3:30 Eastern time next Saturday. It all began with the Auto Trader College Football Today. Next Saturday at 3 o'clock. Anytime we go to Oxford, we all hope we get to see Archie and Olivia.
Smartest guy in the world. He left the committee the first one to leave. Mississippi State, Dan Mullen. They've got games at Arkansas. They host Ole Miss, and they could win a bowl game. They still could get to 10 wins this year.
Yep.
Move on to it.
Yes. Well, Dan Mullen grew up in Manchester, New Hampshire. He was a quarterback at Trinity High School. And he's got 10 of his high school teammates, Trinity class of 1988, who are visiting Dan and Megan and the kids this weekend. I think they hoped for a little more positive outcome than this. But they played basketball yesterday.
Yeah, they did.
Yeah.
Dan was all taped up.
Yep.
After playing basketball.
31 for 70.
Bringing in Fitzgerald now. The backup quarterback's going to get a few snaps. He's the future. Redshirt freshman. Nick Fitzgerald played in an option offense in high school.
13-yard game.
Not really hugely recruited. Very typical of a Mississippi State football player. But Dan, and actually we talked to Dak about Fitzgerald yesterday. He said he's got a really bright future.
The handoff right side. That's Aris Williams, number 27.
Williams on the carry.
Clock now at 4:05. Fitzgerald to the 37-yard line. Stay tuned for the Ram postgame show. That's coming up after our game. We've got 3:40 to go. I doubt that either team is going to want to stop the clock. Maybe enough for a first down. Nick Fitzgerald.
You know, going back, just thinking about that first drive by Mississippi State when they got down there in that red zone and could not push it in.
Right.
Oh, that first stop. When you think about it, we talked about it. You know, Alabama, we figured they're going to score 24 to 35 points. Mississippi State cannot score points against Alabama, cannot produce points. I said they wanted a Big 12 score. They didn't get it.
No. Fitzgerald brought down.
Fitzgerald on the carry.
Dalvin Tomlinson.
Well, this was close to being another sack, was it, behind the line of scrimmage?
1 yard gain. Second down and nine.
Let's see if they give him another sack. Yes, they did. No, they didn't. Got across the line of scrimmage, so it was not. Jeez. Another run?
Wow.
Fitzgerald on the carry.
Now time for the Napa play of the game. We're going to take you back to the first half. And Cyrus Jones gathering this punt in, breaking into the open, heading for the corner. And he winds up strolling in 69 yards. That was one of a number of big plays put together by Alabama en route to this victory.
Fitzgerald to Aris Williams, number 27.
Fitzgerald's pass is complete to Williams.
Well, the longtime lieutenant, Kirby Smart's name's really starting to boil up everywhere around the country. Can't learn any better than Kirby, can't do any better job. The two shutouts, basically he's pitched the last 2 weeks. He stopped the run game, and then he stopped the wide open Prescott pass game. Can't do it any better than Kirby Smart is.
Across the middle, incomplete. No flag. Gabe Miles, the intended receiver.
Yeah, well, he got a chance to throw a couple balls against Alabama, test the waters out here. Obviously, Dak's gone from this team next year, so he'll be one of the guys fighting for that spot.
31-6. And when they get out here, we fully expect knees to be taken.
I'm not sure. I would think that they would run and run the backups and give Damian Harris a few chances to again.
Well, you're right. Which one of us played 13 years in the NFL?
I could have been wrong. I'm just saying, you know, maybe now they'll do it. But I just think he wanted. He's got backup offensive linemen in. He's got a backup quarterback. He lost his running back probably for the year. He wants his other guys to get a little taste of action. I don't see anything wrong with this. You're thinking Auburn now.
Sure. There's Brandon Green, number 58. Dan Mullen. You know, the streak against Alabama will continue. Next year, they've got to go to Tuscaloosa. Bateman. Bo Scarby. And that'll do it. 31-6. Another dominating performance by Nick Saban, Lane Kiffin, Kirby Smart, and a guy named Derrick Henry. Jake Coker played his role tonight. So the updated standings now have Alabama at 6-1, LSU at home against Arkansas later tonight, and next week we'll see LSU at Ole Miss. Let's go down to Allie, who is with Nick Saban.
Coach, before the game, you told me you needed your special teams, your offense, and your defense to play well. Your special teams scored. Defense had 9 sacks, and your offense was outstanding in that second half.
Well, we did a better job of executing in the second half, so we were able to keep the ball a little bit. You know, they threw for a lot of yards today, but we stopped them when we needed to on defense. But it's tough with these guys, especially with Dak and his ability to run the ball. So I'm pleased with the win. We didn't play our best game of the year, but we got a lot to improve on.
The 9 sacks, certainly the best of the season. How were you able to be so dominant?
Well, you know, we thought that the one place where we had a little advantage in this game was our front guys against their offensive line. And we needed to do it with 4 guys rushing, and they did a fantastic job of pushing the quarterback.
Coach, whether you like it or not, our fans would like to know if the cut on your face, if you're okay. They were watching it all
game.
One of those
pass rushers ran into me when he was running on the field on third down, so he was bigger than me, so I just let it go.
We'll have to find out which one it is, and he can run some extra sprints this week.
No, he'll be good.
Thanks, Coach. Congratulations on the win. What an outstanding and dominant performance by this defense. How were you guys able to make such an impact in this game?
I just think it starts in practice. We pride ourselves on getting better each week and just focusing on communication every time we step on the field. And I think we executed well tonight. Everybody did their job. I mean, of course, we gave up plays, but I think overall it was a good performance.
This team just continues to get better each week. How are you able to do that?
Like I said, just in practice. Our coaches stay on us, just not tolerating mediocrity. Just coming out there and try to play to our standard every time we step on the field. And I think we put on a good performance tonight.
Your punt return for the touchdown really got things going for this team. Take us through it.
We actually caught a block, so I just judged the ball. I mean, I saw that they were held up pretty good, and we had them blocked, so I just tried to make a play, just like any time I do on punt return. So it was just a great job by the whole unit.
Is this team good enough to win a national championship?
I think as long as we keep it going, we keep improving. I mean, the sky's the limit for us. I don't think it's no ceiling for our team.
Congratulations on the win.
Appreciate it.
Well, I thought this was going to be a close game, Vern. I really did.
Mm-hmm.
And I think Mississippi State, when they weren't able to score, and then getting those haymakers the way they got them, I think the way Alabama scored shocked Mississippi State, and they could never recover.
Reuben Foster helps celebrate Alabama. One blemish for the season. They've atoned for that in numerous ways. For Gary Danielson and Allie LaForce, I'm Vern Lundquist saying so long from Starkville with the final score, Alabama 31, Mississippi State 6. The Ram postgame show up next after these messages and a word from your local station.